month on, and I'm at the junction where I had that crash, the one that went slightly viral, and I just want to talk about it. So, if you remember the video, I was coming from where that cancelled blue van is there, coming out, cross junction, I was on this side of the van, because if I look to my right, yeah, there's sunlight here. Oh shit, yeah, there we go. Joe, the car is indicating right. That's the second lane, so there's two lanes there now, and I was going right up there. And traffic has stopped all the way along, halfway down the street. So, in my mind, it made sense to go up the outside, so that the clear runs straight at that, as opposed to trying to fart around, because a lot of times the car is stopped in this yellow box here. And that kind of makes it difficult to switch lanes, you have to drive towards the cycle lane. And then you can see how small the gaps are between the cars there as you move up along. So, yeah, like, there, well, that motorbike's gone now. That was tragic, although he's just splitting the lanes. My point in that motorcyclist is he was doing exactly what I just did. He's moving over to the right-hand side of the lane so that he can get a run up the right-hand side of the cars. The point being there is that that's something that's done not just by bicycles but motorbikes too. And in that video, there was a motorcyclist pulled up right at the edge of the yellow box here and asked me, I'm okay. But he was in the position that I came from. So, had he been there sooner, that could have been him in that crash. Now, whether he would be more experienced doing those kind of maneuvers and would have seen it coming and brake to stop sooner, I don't know. Maybe he's better brakes, or I don't know. Yeah, anyway, coming down the outside, and the car starts to pull out from this junction here. And of course she's looking left, up this way, to her left. The car is like, that taxi coming down this way that she has to look out for. She doesn't see anything as she's pulling out, so she keeps pulling out, but keeps looking just in case anything's coming, because as far as I remember, there were cars turning right back to pull into the back of that lorry. So, like this taxi here, you know, pulling out, looking left. He looked right, and that's critical. And you could have a motorbike or a bicycle steaming up the outside, like that BMW. And you can absolutely cream them. She pulled out, didn't see anything, there's none of this traffic here, she didn't see anything, so decided, right, time to go, I accelerated, and at that point I was braking because I could see she was pulling out, because initially it looked like she was stopping, and then as soon as I went for it, she went for it, and at that point we both had too much speed for one of us to correct it. Had she seen me, she could have braked in time, but didn't. Just gotta give me a bit of a look. And so that was the incident. It's not on that video now, it was removed because I left some personal details in accidentally. But how I conducted myself, I'm proud of it. Because initially I was obviously pissed off. I cannot think of anyone who wouldn't be pissed off in that situation of being flattened. The truck driver was great, he's the fellow who said, everybody calm down. That's exactly what needed to happen. And the conversation afterwards was actually probably too informal. I was doing called Gardaí, which I'm not regretting. I was only lightly injured. I came off with a bruise on my inner thigh, and where my shin dented the bonnet, a little bit of pain in the front of my shin, just here. But that was it, and you know, I was walking around fine. At the time I felt less injured even. You know, my ribs weren't sore, my shoulder wasn't sore, I can remember the entire incident, there wasn't any memory loss. So it's called the Gardaí in the sense that it was minor. And the Gardaí genuinely have better things to be doing than attending that kind of incident. Yes, should have been reported on legality front, but yeah. As for the repairs, the driver fully accepted to pay the repairs, which for me was the clincher in not following the Gardaí, because she said, look, well, she said, I didn't see you, I didn't look, so it is my fault. And whether she's right or she's wrong, she said that she is at least partly to blame. I would also admit I am partly to blame for misjudging how that car was moving. Like, I do own my own car, I do drive as well, so I'm probably a bit better armed than people who don't, but at the same time, we can all get it wrong. There's nothing more to say on that one. It's just two of us got things wrong, one of us caught, the other didn't, and there wasn't enough time. Yeah. If you want to see the video of the crash, I'm going to link it just here. You can just click on that little icon and it'll take you to the video. That's for that, I'm out.